Can you guess this animal? I'll give you clues. Bushy tail, lives in a tree, runs around. I think you got it. Tell me. Oh yes, that's it. It's squirrel. It's so cute. Do you know squirrels are members of the family Sciuridae, a family that includes small or medium-sized rodents? The squirrel family includes tree squirrels, ground squirrels, chipmunks, marmots, flying squirrels, and prairie dogs, amongst other rodents. Many kinds of squirrels live in trees, so they often find nuts. Do you know what do they eat? They eat seeds, berries, and pine scones too. Sometimes they eat birds' eggs. Like other rodents, squirrels have four front teeth. Do you know? That never stop growing. What if our teeth grow like this? It sounds funny. It would be nice to see us. Anyway, here we have a poem, The Squirrel, written by Mildred Bars Armstrong. It's very important for us to know something about the poet. Mildred Bars earned her bachelor's degree from Northwestern University in 1923. She also studied at Mount Holyoke College, the University of Chicago, and the University of Wisconsin. Bars titled her first volume of poetry, Twist of Smoke, after the pseudonym she used in college. Twist of Smoke won the 1928 Yale Younger Poets Prize and was published by Yale University Press. Bars also published verse in periodicals under her married name Mildred Armstrong. Squirrel is a very lovely, cute animal with high spirit. It's running here and there. In this short and beautiful poem, the poet describes a squirrel from a child's point of view. Let me recite the poem. He wore a question mark for tail, an overcoat of gray. He sat up straight to eat a nut. He liked to tease and play. And if he ran around his tree, he went the other way. Let's start with first line. He wore a question mark for tail. Here, he refers to the squirrel. What does the poet say? The poet says that the tail of the squirrel looks like a question mark. If you look at the picture, we can see its tail. It is twisted and looks like a question mark. In the next line, the body of the squirrel is compared to an overcoat. Just as in the winter days, we wear an overcoat, and in the same way, the poet says that the body of the squirrel is covered with fur, which is gray in color. So he wore a question mark for tail and overcoat of gray. And let's move on to third lines. And see the next line. He sat up straight to eat a nut. We know that the squirrel loves to eat nuts, isn't it? But did you notice one thing? Whenever he plays, we find the squirrel bending, moving here and there. But while eating, it maintains a particular posture. It sits up straight. The poet was very minute in his observation about the squirrel. See the next line. He liked to tease and play. Here, the poet says squirrel loved to tease and play because they are generally playful, jolly, and they are fun-loving kind of creature. So they like to tease and play. And they ran around the tree. And in the last two lines, and if he ran around his tree, he went the other way. In these lines, we find the human intervention. Here, we refer to the poet and his friends. What does the poet say? He says that he, along with his friends, whenever they run behind the squirrel to capture It runs away. Because, as I mentioned earlier, the squirrel is a playful, funny animal, and whenever someone tries to capture or goes behind him, it will run away. What does he do? It changes its direction immediately. So, if you put in a nutshell, we can say in this poem, a squirrel as described. Firstly, his tail as compared to a question mark. Secondly, his body with a grey fur is compared to an overcoat. Thirdly, his posture, that he is sitting up straight while having nuts, is described. And fourthly, his characteristics of being playful is described by the words tease and play. And finally, human intervention is shown. So, my dear children, I hope all of you enjoy this beautiful poem. And recite this poem 2-3 times. Whenever you see a squirrel, take a photograph and paste his photograph in your notebook. Okay?